Hi, this is Brooke with your Modern Wahine Hawaii social distancing update. We're excited to be talking today with Neal Okabayashi from the Hawaii Bankers Association. Hi, Neal.
Hi, Brooke. How are you doing?
Good. I'm sheltering in place, as we all are. Thank you for taking the time to do this.
I'm glad to do it.
So we wanted to talk a little bit about the ATM fees, because I had read somewhere online that the fees had been waived so people can sort of stay close to home and not have to find their specific banks. Do you want to talk about that?
Yes, I do. One of the things that the federal regulators suggested that banks do when we got hit with this economic impact by the coronavirus was that banks should consider waiving ATM fees, and the Hawaii banks have done so. And what happens is when you use your ATM at your bank, you don't get charged a fee. But when you use your ATM at another bank, and you get charged a fee. Now, your bank's ATM may be a lot further from where you are sheltering in place than, say, another bank's ATM. By waiving the fee, we make it easier and more convenient for you to get your cash out of your account at this other bank's ATM, and you won't get charged a fee wherever that other bank's ATM may be. So I think it's worked well. I think most of the banks in Hawaii have done so. So we're trying to sort of help out everybody in some little bits to help them shelter in place.
That's so awesome. We wanted to, you know, it's heavy on everybody's mind, obviously. People are unable to go to work. People are unable to make a living at this time because we're all trying to flatten the curve and stay home to stay safe. People are talking about rent. They're wondering about mortgage. You know, you had some good suggestions about how people should go around addressing that.
Yeah. Number one, on the subject of mortgage, the banks have traditionally, and this includes the time of the Great Recession back in 2008 to 2011 or so, we tried to help our people in Hawaii by making adjustments to their loans to help them not go into foreclosure. That takes the form of loan modification, loan mitigation. It could be deferring your loan payments or something like that. But I always stress, it's important that you call your banker. You don't have to go see them. You can do it electronically. You can use the phone, because we all want to have social distancing and shelter in place, and then try to work it out with them. And, you know, there are also loans that are available to help you pay your rent. And if you're a small business person, right now the banks are doing what we call the Payroll Protection Program. And it allows small businesses, which includes solo proprietors and self-employed, independent contractors, get a loan really from the SBA, but through your local bank. So those are the little kind of things that help.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much, Neal. Be safe. Wash your hands. Stay inside. And hopefully one day when this is all over, we'll be able to see each other in person.
Yes, that'd be great. Thank you. Appreciate it.